guys, welcome back to another Dyson video. So this is my first month of using Dyson. I have done a video on the pros and cons of investing in a Dyson Airwrap, and today I'm going to use the first smoothening brush for which genuinely I invested in Dyson. So I'm going to start with a smoothening brush first, but if you've not seen the pros and cons, I'm going to quickly recap. So my top pro for buying Dyson is you will have to do away with your antifreeze treatments. So no more chemicals on my hair. I am like, fingers crossed, this is my first month of Dyson, but that's the whole reason, and that I feel is an extreme positive for me. My biggest con for Dyson is that it still requires the time investment. So I cannot just wash and go like my earlier treatments. I have to spend that time. Although now with practice, it's less than 5 minutes for me, but it still is a whole process of connecting Dyson to the socket, adding the instruments that are required, and then going ahead. Anyways, so for today's video, let's start with using the smoothing brush. Now, before I use the smoothing brush, this is the Dyson wand. The Dyson wand has this start and stop mechanism. Then this is the airflow, which goes to low, medium, and high. This is the heat, again the cool, the medium heat, and the high heat. This is how you eject the instrument. So if I put a dryer, easy to add, and you just, and it's out. So this is again easy to add, easy to remove. Now before I start using Dyson, generally because my hair type is heavy, frizzy, and thick, so I'm going to use a leave-in mist. The step 2 is partition. Funny looking face, but I have just done 2 sections right now because I'm going to dry my hair. So this is the Dyson Airwrap hairdryer, which is quite powerful. I can only assume how amazing the Dyson hairdryer is, but this one is also quite nice. Generally when I'm doing, I will not use the hairdryer because I let my hair dry naturally, so it is 80% dry and 20% wet. But today, because I wanted to show you how to use this, I'm going to dry my hair now. Please do not use this on dry hair because in my opinion that little dampness in the hair works well with the smoothing brush. Otherwise it gets very frizzy the third day for me. But if my hair is a little damp, then I'm able to last this salon style smoothing or a blow dry, whatever you want to call it, for at least 4 days. Alright, so my hair is dry now. Because I have thick hair and heavy hair, I always dry my hair from the in-betweens, you know, because that is what is always wet. I have used the heat and the air to high. I generally use air to high, but the heat I use medium. For today, I am going to do high on both, just for learning's sake. But otherwise, it really works well on medium heat as well for the smoothing brush. Okay, I just felt this was wet. Anyways, so remove this and add this one. This is the Airwrap smoothing brush. This is the technology that they talk about, which won't pull your hair but move the brush the way your hair is. It's in the direction that you're moving. It's not going to break your hair. I can 100% guarantee you that my hair breakage using this smoothing brush versus a straightening iron is like absolutely 75% less. I hardly see hair breakage in this, and whenever I used to use a straightening iron, my hair would burn, there would be breakage. So I am all in for the smoothing brush. I mean, 100%, it has changed the way my hair looks. I very rarely should be having bad hair days. Anyways, before I start the smoothing brush, I will again partition my hair, because the more you partition your hair and the more quickly you are able to do, and you are able to create that nice bounce with partitioned hair. Nothing will be left behind. So I am just going to do 4 partitions on the hair, but depending on the length of your hair, the thickness of your hair, you can decide the partition. So let's start. Days that I'm not going out, just the hair dryer also gives me such a nice bounce. I know that once it dries out, it gets a little frizzy, but if I have no plans to go out for the 3 or 4 days, then maybe I might not even use a smoothing brush, just use the hair dryer and get it done. I look so funny. Anyways, we'll start with the smoothing brush. I'm gonna start. You have to create tension in your hair. So when I say tension in your hair, you don't have to pull apart your hair, but I'm gonna hold my hair a bit tightly and then move my brush. Once I start the smoothing brush, there'll be a lot of noise. So I'm just gonna explain the technology quickly and then move on to smoothing. So this is how you move. If I just do like this, there is no tension created in the hair and then the waves still stay. But if I just hold it a little and I start using the smoothing brush, it starts straightening out. So let's start. I won't be able to talk because there's noise, but I'll come a little closer for you so you can see that how it gets straightened. All right. So for the starters, I'm just going to move the brush naturally how I move any brush, because I'm just straightening and not straightening, I'm actually just removing the frizz. Next time when I use the brush on the same hair, I'm going to use the brush from down and then use it like this, because then it creates a lovely bounce. Alright, so this is the smoothing brush used on both sides. Now, can you see just the little curve? You won't be able to see much right now because my still full hair is not done, but you'll be able to see the before and after once the full hair is done. So I'm going to start removing the partitions. Move the brush as is, then from inside. Short frizziness that's happening on top, this will get settled with time. I have read that this very frequently happens in countries which has dry air. I am sitting in aircon in a very controlled temperature, but this still happens and it will stay on for some time. So this is my natural hair. Even if the clip wasn't there, forget this part. This is the waves and this is what a smoothing brush does. It doesn't actually just flatten your hair. It gives a nice bounce. It's practice, okay? I have been using this for over a month and a half now and I have just figured out what works for my hair. So yeah, these are tried and tested methods. It's just that there could be some knack that you require for your kind of hair and you will come to know as you are using it. Can you see the difference? The curls are gone. Can you see the waves? I wouldn't even say curls, the waves that were there, that's just gone. Currently my hair is absolutely flat. I mean, I still love a bounce, and this whole the thing that is going straight looks very bad haircut sort of a thing. So now I'm gonna give a little turn and a bounce to my hair, but for now, even if I'm not going anywhere and just this much, my hair is sorted. Can you see? I don't like this whole straight feeling, so I'm just gonna give it a bounce now. My mirror is this side, my camera is this side, so I have to keep on looking at this screen, but I hope you understand what I'm telling. The air is so powerful that I have to be extremely careful as to which side I'm doing it, because otherwise my whole hair goes haywire. I know people use these partition clips to actually do one side and then open the other side, but I find it easy because my hair is short to do the first round with partition clip and the second round just do it as is. But it's just that you have to be a little careful, and also because I'm doing this sitting down, normally I do this when I'm standing up, and while I'm standing the movement of my hands is comfortable. Currently sitting, the movement is a little restricted, but when you're standing and doing this, the movement is not this bad. Can you see this that's happening? This is what I like. It's not too straight. I still have this side to do, but otherwise it's got a nice bounce. And now I'm just going to do the back of my hair and do one more quick tip that I use. Now that my hair feels like everything is done, before I stop using it and move on to applying a hair serum just for the shine, what I will do is, I have a lot of baby hair and curly hair here near my jawline, these two places. So I will specifically just concentrate on this part. Then the next thing I'll do before I stop using it is, I'll turn my hair upside down, so I look down and my hair will be like this, and then I'll just comb on the back because I can't see, because my front hair is long and my back hair is short, hence it gets difficult for me sometimes to understand whether it's done or not. So for just a second level safety, I'm going to turn my hair and then use Dyson. That is the natural bounce that my hair created. I absolutely love it. This side I'll do it once again because it just went. Yeah, no, it's there. If you are used to styling your hair in a particular partition, you can obviously, like me, comb your hair in that particular partition and just use Dyson one more time. So that's it. I'm going to use the serum, a drop. I always start my serum with my back hair. Then I again emulsify it. I move to the ends. And then again, and then now. Fronts. I don't start the serum with front because then I have a feeling that it gets too oily. So I always start with back because I have a lot of hair. So my hair absorbs the serum. The static created on the hair will stay for some time. So the static on the hair will stay for some time, but it will go away. By the time I'm leaving the house or going somewhere, the static will go away. So my hair stays like this for at least 3 days, like it's fresh out of salon. And the fourth day, the hair still stays like this, but you feel that it's not fresh. That's the only difference. This was the product for which I bought Dyson, and I'm absolutely happy with it. Because I'm sharing the tips and tricks with you, it has taken me around 10 minutes to style my hair with the smoothener. But if I'm just doing it all by myself, it takes me 5 minutes, not more, for the whole process. And it's easy. I'm sure it gets easier as you use it. So far happy. If you have any questions on how to use the smoothener, please write to me and I'll reply. If you see what you have liked so far, please subscribe to this channel. I talk about relatable fashion. I give reviews which are absolutely honest, and I would love to see more of you join my tribe. Bye.